some comments and some questions. We'll take three questions together.
तुम्ही आता जो मुंबईकरांचा कारण मुंबईत आल्यावर आपले प्रॉब्लेम सॉल्व्ह होतात असं राज्यभरातल्या अनेकांना वाटतं, अनेक ग्रुप्स ना किंवा त्या त्या पीडितांना मुंबईकरांना नेमकं काय वाटत असेल या म्हणजे आम्ही गेलं वर्षभर वेगवेगळी आंदोलनं केली म्हणजे आझाद मैदानाच्या म्हणजे मोर्चाला उतरण्यापासून तृतीय पंथांना वोटर्स कार्ड कसे मिळतील किंवा तिथे वोटर्स कॅम्पेन म्हणजे त्यांना मतदाराचं कार्ड कसं मिळेल हेही केलं. कॉलेजमध्ये जाऊन विद्यार्थ्यांशी बोलून वेगवेगळ्या पद्धतीने त्यांना मतदानासाठी राजी करणं मतदानाची आवश्यकता पटवून देणं हेही केलं. या सगळ्यात जेव्हा आम्ही रस्त्यावर उतरायचो म्हणजे मग ते लोअर परेलमध्ये आम्ही फुटपाथसाठी केलेलं आंदोलन असो किंवा काही कचराविषयक काही प्रश्न असो कारण गरवारेचेच काही विद्यार्थी आम्ही ते आमच्यासोबत काम करत होते 6 महिन्यांसाठी की तुम्ही तुमच्या भागातील नागरी प्रश्न आम्हाला लिहून द्या आणि आमच्या वेबसाईटवरून आम्ही ते पब्लिश करायचो आणि मग त्याचा पाठपुरावा कसा करता येईल बीएमसी अधिकाऱ्यांना पत्र लिहिण्यापासून सगळं त्यांना आम्ही एका पद्धतीने असं तयार केलं होतं की नागरी प्रश्न कसे सोडवावे आणि त्याला खूप चांगला प्रतिसाद मिळाला की अनधिकृत झोपडपट्ट्या असायच्या रातोरात उभ्या राहिलेल्या त्या अक्षरशः तोडल्या गेल्या किंवा कचऱ्याचे प्रश्न हे केले गेले. पण जेव्हा आम्ही मोर्चाला उतरायचो ना तेव्हा लोकांना गोळा करणं हे इतकं खरंच कठीण असायचं की 20 अनेक अनेक नागरिक संघ आमच्या बरोबर या कामात होते नाही तर त्यामुळे लोक मुंबईकरांना नेमकं आपल्या प्रश्नांविषयी काय वाटतं तर आमच्या अनुभवाप्रमाणे लोकांना रस्त्यावर उतरवणं किंवा त्यांना वेळच नसतो किंवा ते म्हणतात तसं आम्हा त्यांच्याकडे कदाचित पैशाची पॉवर असेल किंवा त्यांना त्या लेवलवर म्हणजे आता हे पुन्हा आपण त्यांच्याकडे वोटर कार्ड आहे जे फ्लॅटमध्ये राहतात या वोटर्सबद्दल कदाचित आपण बोलत असू कारण म्हणूनच वोट बँक ही झोपडपट्ट्यांमध्ये किंवा निम्न स्तरावरच्या वसाहतींमध्ये जास्त आम्हाला दिसून आली आणि जे तुलनेने म्हणजे आपण म्हणूया त्यांनाही रेल्वेचे वाहतुकीचे सगळे प्रॉब्लेम्स आहेत पण त्यांच्या जगण त्यांना रोज बीएमसीशी पाठपुरावा करावा लागत नाहीये त्यांच्या प्रश्नांबद्दल त्यांच्या घरी पाणी येत आहे तर अशांना फारशी ददात नसते त्यांना उतरायचं नसतं आणि पॉलिटिकली ऍक्टिव्ह व्हायचं नसतं हे आम्हाला दिसून आलं असं मला निरीक्षण मांडायचं होतं.
ललिता
माय क्वेश्चन इज टू मिलिंद सर. सर द प्रजा सॉरी द ऑर्गनायझेशन हॅज ऑफन पब्लिश दीज व्हाईट पेपर्स. So last year the paper that was published was completely like rubbished by the BMC. I mean I read a couple of newspaper articles. So how do you ensure that this hard data that is published is translated into is take first of all like taken in good stride by the local representatives and is you know translated into good work the next year?
I will take three questions at a time.
I have two questions. First to Mr. Muskie, regarding the entire exercise of the report card. Do you feel that in absence of an actual direct democratic exercise where representatives are not selected by the people and are fed to them by a particular party in a particular constituency, do you think that this report card holds any intrinsic ground as to you know what the amendment stands for? To Mr. Bhatt, to Mr. Bhatt, you know, do you feel that you know we are very easily satisfied with the marginal rise in the graph of you know increased female participation in the entire political process? Because you spoke of policies, but policies regarding you know actual female participation in the total political discourse or the exercise of the local representative elections is not too great. So
what do you think about that? Yeah.
Should I go first?
My question is to Mr. Senyapati. You have shown you know the graphs and this one showing the gender equality which is coming. But I think that is coming through the reservations. 33% and this. So this has been a known fact. Okay. So what I'm saying that you also mentioned that the corporators, you know, they are trying to use, you know, their spouse and all that to be, and that is what we observed. Okay, so this thing. What is the solution to that? Is the reservation the solution or no? We need to do something more. What has been your observation? Okay.
We can have one or two more questions because any other question? That's it.
Yeah, sir. I think if we look at 2014 election, Lok Sabha election, or in Delhi 2015 election, right, there is one factor called creation of waves, which are, you know, above everything. Correct. So can you please throw some light on that also? Because that is very important factor based on our experience.
Mm-hmm. We follow the same order with Sanjay.
So your question regarding participation of women, so their active involvement in politics. Of course, reservation is not a complete solution for this problem, but we citizens of this city need to change our perception towards women candidates. I know, has already talked about this. See, through reservations, these ladies get into corporation, but in the first term or second term, they get used to the working of the we can say corporation, they get confidence, and after first term or in last few days or years of the first term also, they start working independently. So we can find Mumbai is a city with we can say highest number of women candidates who have been contesting elections from the general constituencies, getting as well as the if you look at the percent from 27% women representatives in 1992 to 47% women representatives in we can say 2017, they are getting elected beyond the reservation. So we the citizens need to change our perception, because when we talk about corporator asa lagto ki to 24 tas available paiche, tarme apan kay karto are hi bhai hai ही कशी काय उभी राहील. तर कॉर्पोरेटची व्याख्या असं की 24 तास आपला नोकर असला पाहिजे, जेव्हा आपल्याला हवं तेव्हा तो उभा राहायला पाहिजे. लोक कशासाठी जात नाहीत, लोक अगदी जन्मतारखेपासून पॅन कार्ड पासून अगदी मी कित्येक लोकांशी ज्या भेटलो त्याने मला दाखवलं की हे हे काम आम्हाला करायला लागतं. मग लोकांचं पूर्ण असतं ही बाई आहे अरे ही काय करणार, ही आपल्याला उभं राहील का, हिला मध्ये येऊन काय करायचं. मी जसं दाखवलं तसं फक्त काही हार्डली 4 महिला खासदार आपण इथून निवडून दिलेत दिल्लीला, आणि फक्त 13 म्हणजे गेल्या 20-25 वर्षात आणि फक्त 13 आमदार महिला आमदारांना आपण निवडून दिले. म्हणजे हा फॉल्ट फक्त व्यवस्थेचा नाही, हा फक्त फॉल्ट लोकांचाही आहे. दुसरी गोष्ट की आजही ती महिला अवलंबून असते आपल्या फॅमिलीवरती, म्हणजे अनेक गोष्टींसाठी, निर्णय घेण्यासाठी, फंडिंगसाठी किंवा अनेक गोष्टीसाठी. रिझर्वेशन हवंच आहे, रिझर्वेशनशिवाय ती महिला तिथे येऊ शकत नाही. दुसरी गोष्ट आहे, पण ती जेव्हा एकदा महिला तिथे आल्यानंतर तिला तो कॉन्फिडन्स येतो आणि ती काम करू लागते. पण दुसरी गोष्ट घरात असते, तू निर्णय घेऊ शकत नाही, किंवा निर्णय घेतला तर त्या कंपनीसाठी लागणारे पैसे, त्या कंपनीसाठी सपोर्ट, किंवा काम करताना मग 12 तास 24 तास किंवा 18 तास जे काही काम करावं तर फील्डवरती, म्हणजे त्या पुरुष पॉलिटिशियन रात्री 12 वाजता किंवा 2 वाजता आला तरी चालतो, पण बाई पॉलिटिशियन आली तर चालत नाही. मला एका बाईने सांगितलं होतं की मी फक्त अनेक मी जवळ 100 नगरसेवकांशी बोलले कल्याण डोंबिवली आणि मुंबईमध्ये, हा मी जवळ 3 वर्ष गेले हा नगरसेवकांसोबत काम करतोय, त्यांचं असं म्हणणं असतं की म्हणजे खरंच एक माजी महापौर राहिलेले आहेत कल्याण डोंबिवली, त्यांनी सांगितलं होतं की एकच निवडू शकतोय घर किंवा राजकारण. त्यामुळे फक्त काही गोष्टी आहेत, एक तर आपलं परसेप्शन बदललं पाहिजे, दुसरी गोष्ट आहे की रिझर्वेशनची पण तेवढी ठरवू शकता. आणखी एक गोष्ट मगाशी ज्या मॅडम बोलल्या त्याबद्दल बोलेल की आपण नेहमी व्यवस्थेत दोष येतो, कॉर्पोरेटर्सचा दोष येतो, पण ऍज अ वोटर आपण काय करतो. कारण मी जसं मगाशी म्हटलं की इमेज बिल्डिंगसाठी 5 कोटी द्यावे लागतात, नंतर निवडणुकीसाठी 50 लाख ते 5 कोटी करावे लागतात, आणि त्यानंतर आपण अपेक्षा करतो की गुड गव्हर्नन्स आणि करप्शन फ्री आहे म्युन्सिपल कॉर्पोरेशन. मी एकच गोष्ट सांगेल, एका मी नगरसेवकाचा दादर शहराच्या एका नगरसेवकाचा मी इंटरव्ह्यू केला होता, तो जो 4 तास माणूस माझ्याशी कंटिन्युअस बोलत होता, तुम्हाला साहेब एकच सांगतो तुम्ही एक गोष्ट सांगतो त्यानंतर तुम्ही समजून घ्या सांगा. आणि एक मुलगा माझ्या काही दिवस आला होता, खूप मागला होता, मला नोकरी पाहिजे माझे वडील वारलेत. नंतर म्हणे की त्याचा तोच निवडणुकीच्या काळात कॅम्पेनिंगच्या काळात मला मदत करायला आला, आणि निवडणुकीच्या आदल्या दिवशी म्हणतो साहेब माझं काय, म्हणजे त्याला 5,000 द्यावे लागले. आणि त्यांना मला लक्षात आलं की म्हणे मी कितीही काम केलं तरी मला निवडणुकीत पैसे ओतायचेच आहेत, आणि एकदा ओतले ते बाहेर काढायचे म्हणून पुन्हा ओतत राहतो. मग ते एक कोटी होता, दोन कोटी होता, तीन कोटी होता, चार कोटी होता. मी काही नगरसेवक असे बघितले त्यांनी घरं घाण टाकली, जमिनी घाण टाकल्या, बायकांचं सोनं विकलंय. हे कसं, याला तितकीच व्यवसायही जबाबदार आहे, तितकेच आपण पण जबाबदार आहे. मग ते झोपडपट्ट्या असतील किंवा हाऊसिंग सोसायट्या, फरक एवढाच पडतो. झोपडपट्टीला माणूस पैसे घेतो आणि हाऊसिंग सोसायटीवाला काय करतो, मेंटेनन्सची बिलं भरा म्हणतो, जिम लावून द्या म्हणतो आणि बिल्डिंगला कलर काढून द्या म्हणतो. त्यामुळे ही परिस्थिती आज मुंबईमध्ये आहे.
I think I have a very different take on this. Like, I remember 10 years back, my first, like, I stopped when I was in, I was covering this story, like, election results. And now, like, past 2 years, I don't think anything much has changed. Like, if you, so it's, I feel it's not a question about, you know, whether women, why number of women, why men, and reservations and all of that. I think it's a question of general participation, of how we function. When I say that, it means that if you have to stand for elections tomorrow, right, either you need a lot of money or you need to know someone in the party or the in the system or the organization. If you're an independent candidate, there are very few chances of you winning. It becomes really difficult unless you use a lot of money, right? So the system itself, so that process itself is flawed, right? Why should I, who maybe love my constituency, am aware about the problems, I have solutions to, you know, do something about it. I have attended a lot of debates of different, where different candidates, we've got a lot of different candidates to talk about, you know, what they'll do in Lower Parel and other areas. No single person spoke about any policy, they didn't speak about any development that they, or any vision that they had for the local constituency. The salaries that they, these councillors get after elected is very low, right? It's 10,000, sorry. So you imagine, like, these, if these people are spending so much money to get into power, and with a salary of 10,000, right, why do you think, you know, why are they spending so much money for a job of 10,000, right? So we have to ask these fundamental questions. And the solution we think as an organization which we are working on is that we need to work at the ground. People who get elected first to these posts should not be, they should be elected by people right from the bottom, right? So we need to create primaries for even these, for even the candidates who stand for these elections. They should come from, you know, people should elect them right at the beginning, and not when we don't have choice and we have to choose between the, you know, who is the better out of the, you know, two candidates that we don't want.
Okay, so you mean to say that primaries should not be, should be there?
Should be there.
Yeah, so we should have primaries right at the ground.
So in a way, there should be a presidential election, whether for the parliamentary top seat or this one.
Okay, about the particular case that you spoke about, I'm not sure whether everybody has a visibility on it, but a few days back, so we do these white papers on different issues. A particular paper on malnutrition and health were contested by the corporation. We in fact got a notice of declaring as a persona non grata, which is, anyway, we know the story. Dada Sahib and Shinaji are here and they have an insight into data. So like, we show you a mirror to them. I mean, the report cards, the way it's designed, even the white paper, the way it's designed, it's like a mirror. जो मिरर पे दिखेगा वही दिखने वाला है. अगर रास्ता खराब है तो मैं रास्ता खराब ही दिखाऊंगा, मैं डेटा दिखा रहा हूँ. Somebody is, if I am naive and serious, nobody is going to give a pushback. I think I'm a stupid person. There's obviously pushback which happens. This is the first time probably the pushback came out in the media, and that's why people came to know about it. Believe me, we have been doing, like, I've been with the organization since early 2010. We started the first, I'm the person who really started the first report cards or the white papers and all that. Every white paper, every report card, every document that we have come up with, somebody has felt bad about it. And there is a pushback which has happened. So how we tackle it? Well, simply, I would say there are three guiding principles that we have. We are objective. We are a data-driven organization. वी ओनली यूज डेटा. मेरा मत क्या है, मेरा ओपिनियन क्या है, हम लोग किसी भी रिपोर्ट में नहीं आते. इफ यू रीड एनी ऑफ आवर डॉक्यूमेंट्स, इट्स ओनली डेटा एंड द इन्फ्लुएंस दैट वी राइट इज लाइक इट्स नंबर ऑफ कंप्लेंस हैव मूव्ड फ्रॉम एक्स टू वाई, पॉजिटिव और आई मीन नेगेटिव, दैट्स इट. वी आर नॉट इवन मेकिंग एनी कॉमेंट ऑन इट. द ओनली एडिटल पीस दैट वी राइट इज अ फॉरवर्ड, दैट्स इट. I mean, it's like a story of what is the main picture, the big picture. The second guiding principle that we have is being non-partisan. As an organization, we speak to all political parties, we speak to all people with all ideologies, and treat them very equally. May it be media, may it be political party, may it be organization. For me, anybody who walks into the office of Prajna, all of them are equal. And that's the way we approach them. We talk to all of them with equal respect, and we spend enough time with them and try to understand their views and all that. There's a clear non-partisan approach that we have. We are not leftists, we are not centralists and all that, right? The third guiding principle that we have in the organization is being collaborative. So it's not we against them, it's we and them together. That's the way we approach it. In fact, the controversy which happened of both the paper was because many councillors and some of the MLAs actually stalled the workings of the house and the assembly because of the data that was raised in the white paper. And this way, people across political parties. So the BJP people actually tried to raise this issue. The last session that we had, the budget session of the state assembly, some of the BJP MLAs have actually written questions based on the data, and they have raised and they have actually asked their government to give an answer. And now, we can achieve that only if we sit with them and we talk to them and we make them understand what it is. But even if we follow all these three approaches, definitely there's going to be people who are going to push, and you have to stay there. Like. I think to that issue, it was very interesting because when we called for a conference to actually give our side of story, at a very short notice, almost everybody who is a civic activist and was available on that day, and actually we just sent out a message in the evening, and the next afternoon, they all were there for a press conference. So I think the city has people who are going to stand by you if you follow, a method, and you are not non-partisan, you're objective about your way, and you don't have an agenda to grind. Right? The only agenda that we had to grind is to make democracy work. That's it. I kind of lost the question.
I could repeat it. I wish to know what is your take on, the entire report card exercise that you are having. In absence of a true direct democratic exercise at the local self-government levels where representatives are given by parties rather than people electing their representatives. So the entire evaluation process becomes flawed at the very ground, to me at least. This can be debatable, of course. But that's how I look at it. Because when you cannot identify with your own representative, how are you supposed to vouch for his credibility?
I always hated school. Because there were exams. But that's the way the system works. I think my answer is that. There's a way the system works. You follow the system and you try to evaluate the system. I mean, we all hate it. So there's a system which is there. You try to evaluate the system and the performance in the system, assuming there are flaws, and then take into accordance those flaws. In fact, when we designed a report card, there was a particular flaw in the report card, the first 3 years, and that flaw was not because we didn't know it, we knew the flaw. So we spoke about number of questions and the quality of questions, and there's one more point which was participating in the discussions. So data for participating in discussions for the councillors was not available, for the MLA is still not available. So the participation of in the discussion under RTI from the assembly, you only get it after 3 or 4 years. You can't do annual report card based on a 4-year-old data. Similarly, in the corporation, it was not available in the first 3 years. We actually got the corporators who raised this issue to say that why don't you guys go and fix the system? Get us the data. I mean, you guys are actually discussing our issue. Why should not the data be available under RTI to the citizens so that it can go back to your constituencies? We want to take your work back to your constituencies. They fixed the system, got them to give us data immediately. fourth year onwards we had it. So you, it's an incremental thing. You need to create, you need to start somewhere. Free Abelian has a concept of directly elected mayor, and that's what they want to achieve, and they say that for them, that's a game changer. Probably for me, it's not a game changer. Probably for Sanjay ji, it's something else. But we need to start those discussions and start moving the ball towards it. Like. So, aaj ke tarikh mein shayad, it's not a foolproof system, but we are making a start somewhere. We are not for a moment saying that it's a perfect system. We are not for a moment saying that tool is perfect. We are open for discussions. We are open to change it. But it has to change in a methodical and a systemic way. You can't do ad hoc change over it.
प्रादेशिक पक्ष जिकडे तो जिकडे ते मत त्या पक्षाचे मतदार आहेत किंवा तिथे तो काम करतोय असं साधारण चित्र होतं आपण म्हणूया गेल्या 10 म्हणजे अगदीच आपण गेल्या निवडणुकीच्या आधी असं आपण म्हणूया पण आता ते चित्र थोडं बदललेलं दिसतंय वरपासून खालपर्यंत आमचे असतील तर काम करणं सोपं जाईल असं अनेक वेगवेगळ्या स्ट्रॅटेजीज वापरून किंवा प्रादेशिक पक्षांशीच गटबंधन किंवा युती करून ती वेळ मांडण्याचा प्रयत्न केला जातो असं चित्र दिसतं
असंही जे हे 2014 आणि 2017 निवडणुका सोडल्या तर पी एम सी विधानसभा लोकसभेच्या निवडणुकीत असं क्लिअर कट रिलेशन दिसतच नाही म्हणजे मी थोड सगळा डेटा काढला एवढा बसून नंतर मी विचार केला की जेव्हा मी पेपर बनवू की नको मग मी ठरवलं की ठीक आहे पी एम सीचं वेगळं विधानसभेचं वेगळं लोकसभेचं वेगळं तसं असतं तर जेव्हा जेव्हा मुंबईत काँग्रेसला 5-5 3 लोकसभेच्या सीट्स मिळाल्या तेव्हा कदाचित तेवढ्या सीट्स त्यांना मिळवता आल्या असत्या पण खरं तर नगरसेवकाचं कामच वेगळं असतं यू वर्क्स बियॉन्ड द पार्टी जो पार्टीचा स्टॅम्प किंवा सिम्बॉल ते गरजेचं असलं तरी नगरसेवक हा खूप इंडिपेंडेंटली काम करत असतो पार्टी एजेंडापेक्षा किंवा पार्टी आयडियॉलॉजीपेक्षा पण जरी शिवसेनेची आयडियॉलॉजी जरी वेगळी असली तरी शाखा लेवलला किंवा त्यांच्याशिवाय नगरसेवकांशी बोलतो तेव्हा तिथे सगळेच बसलेले असतात तो सगळ्यांना त्याला हे अक्रॉस नगरसेवकांच्याकडे दिसतं त्यामुळे 2014-17 निवडणुका सोडल्या तर मला नाही वाटत फार असा संबंध त्या लोकसभा विधानसभा ऍटलीस्ट मुंबईच्या बाबतीत तरी दिसतो त्यात नगरसेवकच काम खूपच वेगळं असतं
सर प्रोडक्ट आय थिंक वेव्ह इज काइंड ऑफ द फर्स्ट स्टेप टू इट राईट बट द वेव्ह इफ नॉट सपोर्टेड बाय अ व्हेरी सॉलिड ऑर्गनायझेशन अँड ऑर्गनायझिंग मुवमेंट इट डझंट स्टॉप राईट वेव्ह कॅन जस्ट फॉर एक्झाम्पल इवन आम आदमी पार्टी अँड ऑल दॅट लाईक द वे दीज ऑर्गनायझेशन्स आर एबल टू लाईक यु नो get people on the ground and go and canvas. I think that was really what gave that wave, you know, that impetus. Same goes with like BJP winning in Northeast and all of the other things.
So finally it's time to close the session, but just 3 observations after the whole deliberation. One is, I was expecting at least somebody would talk something on because this being election thing and Mumbai is considered to be a one compact kind of a constituency. Nobody unfortunately talked on one nation, one election, maybe some, at least one or two figures on that could have really enriched the discussion and that would have led some more questions on that. Secondly, there are different kinds of initiatives which are talking in terms of, you know, changing the system, changing the, you know, the way these corporators are thinking and whatever initiatives in order to cleanse the system, that is what, and finally, I mean, let's close this session with one final remark, and that is, if there is a wave, I mean, can Mumbai experience some anti-wave also sometime?
I would like to take this opportunity to thank our session chair, Dr. Mridul Nile, and all our speakers, Sanjay Patil, Bini Kaul, Suchita Deshpande, and Milind Maske. This session has definitely given us various perspectives on politics. And most of us being students of politics, this has definitely been an engaging and enlightening session. So before we call it a day, tomorrow is day 3 of Mumbai Talks. The first session begins at 10 o'clock in the morning, and it's governance issues in Mumbai. The session will be chaired by Dr. Vaibhavi Parsure. The second session begins at 11:45, which is development security and other challenges. And the session will be chaired by Dr. Rashmi Puri. Thank you. And I want to thank each one of you for being such lively audience. Thank you.